It is. Sound a little bit too low? Let me know if the audio's not good enough or...
Hey, you!
Hey. Oh, man. Oh, God, this is so comfy. I'm just gonna lie here and suffocate on my own vomit now.
I had a thing I wanted to tell you.
Uh-huh. This room sure looks... different when it's spinning.
So I was browsing through the used book ads in the paper when I...
Listen, Eileen, I'm totally excited about books right now, but...
Wait, hear me out! So I noticed this article about a war veteran from Conwell Springs who just died. I remembered that you used to live there and everything, and...
Oh, how I wish for joyful, blissful sleep.
And get this! His name was Joseph. Joseph Rain.
What did you just say?
You knew him, right? I knew it! I knew you'd know him!
I haven't seen him since I was a kid. A lifetime ago. Hey, wait a minute. I never told you where I grew up.
Oh, well, I might have sort of looked you up.
That is not cool, Eileen. Seriously.
I just couldn't help myself.
Well, one of these days you're gonna help yourself to a restraining order. I'm just telling you this as a friend.
I know. Well, anyway, you should know that the funeral is tomorrow.
Okay.
Are you gonna go?
I don't know. Good night, Eileen.
Good night, Kathy.
Oh, God, make it stop. Looks like Eileen left a note for me here. Hi, Kat. Since it's such a long drive, I set the alarm so you won't miss the funeral. Thank me later, E. I'm so getting a new roommate. Well, I guess I should get going. I'm late enough as it is. Eileen borrowed it from school. She takes a bunch of computer classes.
I have no idea what this game is about, but me neither. I haven't looked at the trailer, I haven't read anything. I love the art style, I love the game type. That's fucking awesome. So... it's gonna be a good game, I already know that.
Well, here we are. God, I really need a smoke. Does anyone object? Guess not. Dead people rule.
She just threw it. Oh. Maybe I should have stayed there for a while.
A family mausoleum. The family must have been fairly rich. Those things don't come cheap. It says price.
We are gathered here today to honor a person of great integrity, a pillar of the community, and a decorated war hero. His name was Joseph Irving Rain. We all remember his warm heart, his compassion, and his eagerness to help others. His passing, while our loss, is surely heaven's gain. Now we entrust our brother Joseph to God's mercy. We commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, in sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, who will transform our frail bodies so they may be conformed to his glorious body, who died, was buried, and rose again for us. To him be glory forever. Amen.
Oh, Kathy, you big baby, just talk to her. Excuse me, Mrs. Rain?
Have we met, hon? You look strangely familiar.
It's me. It's Catherine.
Catherine who?
You don't recognize me? I guess it's been a while. I might be a bit taller than you remember me.
Kathy? Bless my soul. Look at you, all grown up. Oh, how I wish Joseph could see you now, finally coming home.
Let's hope he can. Wherever he is.
A comforting thought, dear. Lord, how long has it been? 10 years? 15?
15 sounds about right. I was 6 when Mom took me away.
Goodness, we have some catching up to do then. I want to know everything. Listen, I'm not quite ready to leave yet, but why don't you join me at the house in half an hour?
Sure, I'd love to. I passed it on my way here. It shouldn't be too hard to find.
I'll see you soon, then. I'm so glad you found your way back home. I can't wait for us to have a chance to talk.
Same here. See you in a bit. Rest in peace, Grandpa. I wish things could have been different. The coffin is lowered, but the grave hasn't been filled up yet. Mary Elizabeth Rain, my grandmother on my father's side.
I wonder if these are like backers or anything like that. So this is set in 1990s then. Oh shit, whoops.
Thanks.
If you wish to find God, the Church of the Holy Trinity is always open to you.
Is that so?
Here, have a brochure. It's never too late to turn away from the path of sin.
And what makes you so sure I'm on a sinful path, Father? Wouldn't you say that prejudice is but a small step from the 7 big ones?
I simply meant that we are all sinful creatures, child. I hope to see you at the church.
Don't get your hopes up, buddy.
I'll pray for you. I wish you comfort in this time of grief.
On tombstones, it's tolerable. I wonder if anything happens, or is it just like a repeat? Looks like a repeat.
Grandma, anybody home?
Oh, hello, dear. I was just wondering what took you so long.
Sorry, I couldn't resist taking that old wheelchair for a spin. Oh, don't give me that look. I put it back.
You haven't changed one bit. Always kidding around, just like when you were little. Come have a seat. We have so much to talk about.
Oh, everything just seems to be all joy and whatnot, you know.
So, now, tell me about your life in the city.
Oh, there's not much to tell. I'm going to school for journalism. It's my second year. I ride a motorcycle in case you missed it there out front.
Ah, oh, that's right. Just like your father.
Yeah, I suppose.
I must ask, have you heard anything from your father? Anything at all?
No, nothing since he bailed way back then.
I expected as much. He disappeared without a trace. No matter, that's ancient history. How's Sharon, then?
Mom is... I had her committed to a place where she could get some real help. I just couldn't take it anymore.
I'm sorry to hear that. In spite of everything that happened when she took you away.
Yeah, about that. I'm sorry I didn't visit sooner, Grandma. Mom, she told me all these horrible lies about you and Grandpa. When I was old enough to understand what she was doing, I felt like it was much too late.
It wasn't your fault, dear. You were a child. I'm just happy that you're here now.
Me too. So, what about you? How have you been doing all these years?
I've been lonely ever since the accident. There's no denying that.
What accident?
Goodness gracious. Of course you don't know. She took you away before it all happened.
Don't know what?
I will never forget that dreadful day. August 16th, 1981. It was the middle of the night when Sheriff Truman knocked on our door. He had Joseph with him. I couldn't even recognize Joseph at first. All dirty and wet with an awful blank stare on his face, like his soul had been ripped from his body. Since that day, he never spoke a word. Forever confined to that blasted wheelchair.
Really? For all this time? I had no idea.
It came as a shock to all of us.
That's horrible, Grandma. I'm so sorry.
Thank you, dear.
Oh, shit, okay. Pills with an ad back at the NPCs where you could see the NPC's backstory. Really immersion breaking off. I've still yet to play a lot, like, through Pills of Eternity. I got stuck at one point now and just, it was impossible, or I just couldn't find out where to go next or something. I need to go back to it.
Why do you think Grandpa suddenly left that night in 81?
I haven't the faintest idea. He acted very peculiar not long before it happened, disappearing for hours at a time. At first, I even suspected he was having an affair. When I asked him about it, he just said he was chasing old demons. Must have had something to do with the war.
Maybe it was post-traumatic stress disorder? Grandpa always had a hard time showing weakness.
I don't know, dear. I'm just speculating. I didn't think too much of it at the time. Joseph was a man of few words. I'm sure he just didn't wish to burden me with it, whatever it was.
Yeah, I've had it since it came out. I got stuck on it.
What did the doctors have to say about Grandpa's condition?
Persistent vegetative state. That's what they call it. I've heard it all by now. One doctor said it was a stroke. Another claimed it was a seizure. The third hack tried to sell it off as a severe infection. It's all a load of tripe. I had an MRI performed on Joseph. It's one of those state-of-the-art head scans.
Yeah, I've heard of them.
Yes, well, according to the scan, his brain was completely intact. They thought it was a technical problem at the time, some kind of glitch, but the result was the same after three different scans on three different machines. Eventually, they had to confess that they simply had no credible explanation for the state he was in.
And this injury just happened to occur on the very same night he mysteriously disappears?
Indeed. I refuse to believe it was a coincidence.
What did Sheriff Truman have to say about the matter?
Not much. He said they simply found Joseph in that condition on the outskirts of town. The sheriff was convinced there was some kind of foul play involved, but the investigation turned up nothing. He later said that he was sorry, but that he was forced to close the case.
You know, I could try to find out more about this.
You're welcome to...
Okay, I think I'll head over to the sheriff's station for a little chat then. Would be nice to witness police doing some actual police service for once.
Sure, you go ahead. Let me know if I can be of any more help.
I'd keep my hand off the mouse.
What do you think about this church, Grandma?
They seem harmless to me, but they can be a bit pushy at times.
Huh, you could say that. Handing out pamphlets at funerals is in pretty bad taste.
Awfully strange behavior for a priest, I'll give you that.
Just get the shit out of me, love.
Sorry.
I don't want to show her that.
Kathy Rain. Yeah.
I don't want to show her that. She'll just start worrying about me.
I bet she just started it.
I already talked. See you later, Grams.
Take care, dear.
So, it starts off with... it seems like she's at school, at university, that type of thing. And, she's drunk or something, and her roommate says that she's sitting... pretty much her grandpa has died. So, but it's like back in the hometown where her mum took her away when they were little. And she's come back to see, basically go to the funeral and see grandfather. It's on the dad's side, not mum's side. And then, so they've had the funeral. She has obviously recognised them and then said, you know, come over, see us, see me after the funeral. And then they've just spoken about the grandpa had an accident a few years back where he literally came back from the, from somewhere, we have no idea where, like black, covered in mud, just staring blankly with no expression on his face, and then he was confined to a wheelchair for the rest of his life. Not saying a word, ever. Apparently. So, I'm gonna go work out what happened. Yeah, he's dead now. That's who the funeral was. So, look at the phone book. Ghost throne, exactly.
Nah, nothing like that in here. It's a phone book. I should be able to use this for looking up phone numbers of people or places in town.
Rides a motorbike, which is cool. No, I haven't. Not yet.
Hi.
Hello.
Do I have to commit a crime to get your attention? Because I seriously will.
Ma'am, I'm really quite busy at the moment. Hey, wait. I know you.
I'm pretty sure you don't.
Yes, I do. You're Kathy. Kathy Rain.
My reputation precedes me. In a kind of, but not totally, creepy way.
Aw, oh, come on. It's me, Lenny. Lenny Marks.
I'm drawing a blank.
Really? You don't remember us playing when we were little kids?
Not really. Sorry, buddy.
Darn. Well, that's a bummer. Anyway, what can I do for you today?
I wanted to ask if you know anything about my grandfather's accident.
I really don't know much beyond the rumors. The sheriff may have more information, but even he probably doesn't know anything that isn't in the report. It happened before either of us worked here.
Okay, I think I'll have a chat with the sheriff then.
Sure thing. His office is to your right.
Stunning.
Well, gotta go.
See ya.
Do you want to listen? You on for longer, Will? A little bit longer.
Just some photo. Oh. I can't see it clearly from here. Hello, Sheriff. Do you have a moment?
Not really. Make it quick.
Do you know what happened to Joseph Rain in 81?
He had a stroke in the woods. That's what happened.
If that's all there is, why would Sheriff Truman open an investigation?
It was just standard procedure. A general occurrence report always has to be filed.
I see. Did you know him at all?
No, I haven't been in town for long. Man sure has one hell of a reputation, though. It's been over a decade since he was put in that wheelchair, and people still talk about the man he used to be. It's like he was a cult leader or something.
Sounds like a conspiracy theory to me.
Could be, but you know what they say. Things too good to be true usually are.
Could I have a look at that report?
Absolutely not. They're official police documents.
Why not? I thought filed police reports are public record.
Not in this state, they ain't.
Huh.
But I'm family. Doesn't that count for something?
You consider yourself family? I've never even seen you before in this town.
It's complicated.
Guess what's complicated? Not to mention illegal. Handing out evidence to anyone who asks for it.
Sheriff had a charming personality. More like a cunt, but whatever.
Aw, come on, Sheriff. What's the big deal? It was a long time ago. It would make this girl very, very happy.
Are you trying to use flirtation on an officer of the law? Well, that shit may work on numbnuts like Lenny, but I got work to do.
Lenny, a little help here? Don't you agree that he's taking by the book too far?
Well, boss, she is his granddaughter, really. I don't think it's any...
Don't you think I know that? There are rules. Am I the only one in here who cares about the law?
Too much coffee? Try not to pop a vein.
You want to see the inside of a cell?
Oh, cuff me, officer. Spare me the torment of your rhetorical questions and veiled threats.
Just follow the rules like everyone else. I've had enough of this nonsense.
Fine. Tons of miscellaneous files. I don't see anything labeled as police reports, so those must be elsewhere. Lots of police reports.
How's the paperwork?
I would, but
on,
I can't do that when he's right there.
Okay,
maybe
I
can distract
maybe
him somehow.
Through.
That's no good. We're gonna have to cancel lunch today.
Again? Oh, man.
Your motivation.
Hey, Lenny.
Hello, Kathy. What's up?
Hey, I need to see the police report from 81 when my grandfather was found by the old sheriff.
I'd love to help, Kathy. The files are right here behind me. But you better check with the sheriff first.
Okay, I'll do that. I don't want to show him.
Distract, use a sun gun.
Go.
See ya.
Looks like talking isn't going to help me get that report. I'll have to take matters into my own hands. I wonder what's behind those doors. That company.
Wait.
Yeah, that won't get me into trouble.
God, I thought she was gonna do it.
I need you to do something.
How can I help us?
I was hoping.
It's my mother's birthday this weekend. You'll have to get her again.
What's up, bruh?
Hey.
What? I can't hear you.
Hey.
Hi there.
You need to keep the blonde cop out there busy for a while.
I do?
$10 says you do.
I'd say my services in this matter are worth at least $20.
$9.
$15.
$8.
Fine, $10.
$7.
Deal.
Good.
So, what am I doing again?
Distract that young cop in the lobby. I don't care how you do it, as long as you keep him occupied for a while.
Okay, then. Let me know when.
Will do. Too heavy to carry around. Brilliant idea to leave those lying around next to evidence lockers and locked cells.
True.
I'll need a key. If I ever need to find evidence, they look sturdy enough. Wouldn't be able to break them open without taking my time and making a lot of noise.
Hey, the jail is off limits. You shouldn't be in there.
Oh, sorry. I just heard someone yelling. I think that guy in the cell needs some help.
Ah, what now?
Okay, I have to make this quick. Okay, let's have a look.
An individual was encountered on the side of the dirt road a few miles from Como Springs, blindly walking forward with his eyes wide open. The suspect was identified as Joseph Rain. He did not respond when touched or spoken to. He appeared to be dirty from head to toe and wet up to his knees. Mr. Rain was fiercely clutching a small tape recorder, complete with tape. Being cooperative, he could be led into the squad car and transported back to town. Same day, picked up Miss Rain and brought her along with Mr. Rain to the emergency room in the community clinic. At the community clinic, upon routine inspection of the patrol car, a tape recorder was found discarded on the back seat, found with evidence in locker 5.
I'm gonna have to get my hands on that recorder. Okay, let's find the key to locker number 5. Got it.
Did it for me? Oh. Be interested in what he wants.
Hey, Lenny.
Hello, Kathy. What's up?
What happened to the bomb? Look what
well,
I got.
I see ya. Hey, Sheriff. What's the deal with that bomb?
What bomb?
All right, got it.
Note to self. Remember, the perfect bouquet consists of 3 red roses, a blue violet, and 2 yellow tulips. I've been working on my research in the attic at night.
He's gone nuts.
I just don't want her to worry. She has enough to think about with everything that's been going on lately. With Sharon and Kathy. Anyway, I'm getting closer to finding the source. I have a theory, but I need help. I'm gonna have to involve somebody else. I've been working on my research in the attic at night.
The bouquet is surely a code.
Hey, Kathy, wait.
What?
Do you eat foot? I mean, food?
Absolutely not. I feed on human misery. Relax, Lenny. Yes, I do eat food.
Oh, well, great. Can I buy you food sometime? And also buy food for me? And then maybe we could eat the food together?
I'm really busy right now. Maybe later.
Oh, okay.
See. Denied. Denied. I need sacred foot.
I should probably ask Grandma first.
Yeah.
Hmm?
Oh, hello, dear.
Mind if we talk for a bit, Grandma?
Not at all, dear. What's on your mind?
Would you mind if I took a look in the attic?
I suppose it would do no harm. Come with me.
Thanks, Grandma.
You're welcome, dear. Be careful now.
Yeah. We should know where it is.
The bulb looks burned out. I'll have to replace it.
Bulb. Stun gun.
I don't see how those things work together.
I do.
Nah, it's drafty in here and almost out of fuel. Gonna need it for my smokes.
Fair enough. You fucking druggy. I mean, smoky. Couldn't just find another
free
one.
Free light bulb. Score.
Sure, let me sing you the song of my people. I see green, I see fields of green, red roses too. A bunch of place where I'll murder you.
There we go.
Yay. Light.
Various books and office supplies. Nothing in particular catches the eye. Empty.
Oh, it's the red, yellow, and blue. Mm-hmm. Pie.
An old typewriter covered in cobwebs.
English is hard.
Just some old bills. Nothing interesting. Yeah. I'm good, thanks. Decades old coffee. Lovely. It looks like someone was doing geometry. I can't make much sense of it. I've already searched. A worn office chair on wheels. I'm feeling a sudden urge to do a race. Just some old. An old type.
I think I've already got Dead Island Game of the Year. I think. This will be the code.
Nope. A leather briefcase. Nope.
I lost it in a non-dominant hand fapping accident.
Note to self. Remember, the perfect bouquet consists of 3 red roses, a blue violet, and 2 yellow tulips.
Three red roses. A blue violet. A yellow tulip. Three red violets.
Note to self, I've been working on. Note to self, remember the perfect bouquet consists of three red roses, a blue violet, and two yellow tulips.
So, three red roses. What's the roses bit? Roses, R-O-S-E-S, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 4, 5, 6, 7, no.
Note to self, remember the perfect bouquet consists of three red roses, a blue violet, and two yellow tulips. I've been working on my research in the attic at night. I just don't want her to worry. Note to self.
Yeah, there's a bit too many numbers there, mate. Six numbers. It'll go to nine. Well, zero, technically.
I must be missing something. What was that weird first message on the tape? Nope. 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 Maybe Grandpa mentions a total of six flowers in the message. There's also six digits in the code. I feel like I'm so close to figuring it out. Nope.
No. Three red roses. Yeah, I know what you mean. Two, three, five.
Nope. That. Nope. 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 I don't think anything of that combination makes.
I've been working on my research. Note to self. Remember, the perfect bouquet consists of 3 red roses, a blue violet, and 2 yellow tulips.
Nope, that's not it. That action. That combination. That action doesn't seem productive to me. I don't see how those things. Nope, that's not it. The tape grip. Nah, no need to.
I've been working on my research. Note to self. Remember, the perfect bouquet consists of 3 red roses, a blue violet, and 2 yellow tulips.
What are the flowers representing? The roses. The violet and the tulip needs to represent something. Hmm? Yeah, but which ones? That's the question, Sacred.
Oh, hello, dear.
Mind if we talk for a bit, Grandma?
Not at all, dear. What's on your mind?
I found a locked briefcase in the attic. Do you know anything about it?
Oh, that old thing? Joseph said they were just some old boring Air Force papers in there.
If that was the case, why use an intricate combination lock?
That's a very good question, dear. In any case, I wouldn't know how to open it.
I found this book in the attic. Recognize it?
Oh, yes. I bought it for Joseph's birthday once. He was always fascinated by numbers. He believed that math could explain everything in this world.
He was a man of science. There's no denying that.
And all the game's too intensive for my computer, so it can only do 40 FPS.
Hey, Grandma, do you recognize this tape recorder?
Oh, yes, Mr. Dicto. Joseph used to carry that thing with him everywhere. He could be absent-minded at times. It helped him remember things.
I got the dictaphone already. I don't think there's anything else in there I need to mention to her. I already talked to her. I don't want to show.
Hmm. So I need to work this off by ourselves.
See you later, Grams.
Take care, dear.
A decent-sized book collection. Most of them science or history-related from the looks of it. Would be kind of funny to see her reaction, but no. Grandpa in his Air Force uniform. Looks to be in his early 20s. I used to love digging through those drawers when I was a kid, looking for coins, buttons, and trinkets. Grandpa and me, we had this game where he would hide pennies around the house and I would go on a treasure hunt. Never in the attic, though. I thought it was too scary up there. I used to love digging... Grandpa never... A robust piece of wooden... Nice leather chair. Freckles, the old farm cat, used to love that thing. Nah, I'm more... Grandma has prepared some tea... I remember playing with that. Grandpa had a whole collection of them. An intricate toy airplane with moving parts. A decent size... This paint looks fresh. Grandma must have had this restored recently. Cute red horse. It's some old Swedish thing, I think. A wedding photo from when my grandparents married. They look younger than I am now. Things have sure changed.
Oh, double, how you doing, mate?
It's a photo of this very farm from way back. It says June 12, 1910 in the corner. Some kind of winter forest scene. I've always wondered if it's supposed to be Conwell Woods or not.
Cool. Everyone's here.
A mere single pair of boots on display. Boy, do we live in different worlds. It was a joke, you know. An old wheelchair. Not too dusty. Probably used recently.
You watching our Hitbox? Good idea.
I wonder why Grandpa ended up in that thing. Nice black leather coat. Right up my alley. Nice black leather coat. Dog fighting. Grandpa used to love that stuff.
Foot. Sacred foot?
That combination makes no sense. I don't see... That action doesn't seem productive.
Why walk up to it then and make me feel like something's gonna happen?
I don't see... That action... That combination makes no sense.
Oh, walk up to it then. Stun it. Oh.
I don't want to zap. I don't want to burn that.
Why?
That combination makes no... That action doesn't seem productive to me.
Ugh. Combine all the things, exactly. I'll be streaming D-O-T-T. D-O-T-T. I'm gonna hit myself when you fucking write it out now. I'm just gonna be like, twat. idea of the tentacle. Ah, okay. I haven't heard of it, so that's fine. Well, I have heard of it. I've seen it on like some key sites and Steam and all that stuff, but I've never actually played it. Oh, you know, shit. I'm sorry. 3141.
Yeah, that would have been too easy. I doubt the book alone is enough to solve this.
The book alone, right? I know the book alone.
I don't see how.
Fucking.
I've been working on. Note to self. Remember, the perfect bouquet consists of 3 red roses, a blue violet, and 2 yellow tulips. I've been working on my.
Three red roses. Red. Three red, 1 blue, 2 yellow. I just don't understand. The roses have to mean something. Red roses. Yeah, we're all gonna fucking facepalm when we finally work this out. We're just gonna be like, for fuck's sake. 357. 1 blue. Violet. V-I-O-L-E-T 8 Tulip T-U-I-L-I-P 9
Not it.
Nope. 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 A leather briefcase sealed by a combination lock. A leather Nope. I don't want to That combination Not the worst idea, but I think I'll hold on to it for now.
Yes, sure, I'm still at the fucking lot. I'm gonna go for a piss while I think about this. Realize this. Ugh. I'll do it later, shut up about it. Oh. First number's 23. Okay, right, we'll go on that. 23. Yes. Go on, Torben. How you doing? Show me the book again. Okay. We shall decipher this. Three red roses. A little frustrated, just a little bit. I'm trying to work this thing out. It's like one of the first big puzzles in the game, and I'm just like, doy. I'm just absolutely like confused. Right. Yeah, no, 235, 251, 11. You've got two more numbers. Not 11. 31. 51. 31. I want you to, like, give me a detailed description how you fucking figured this out, Dorple, afterwards. If you do it. I don't want you to just read them from some fucking cheap little site. You bastard. No. I'm under the assumption that you probably kind of know puzzles quite well. 2, 3, 1, 5, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 5, 3, 1.
Nope,
nope.
That's not it.
Oh, 51. Whoops. Tired, shut the fuck up.
Yes!
Explain now. Explain, fam. Yeah. Right, so 2, 3. 3 others, so 2, 3, 5. It's one of these. Also, 2, 3. Oh no. Nope. 2, 3, 5, 1. I did. For my life. No, we've worked it out.
It's the envelope I found in the briefcase. Let's see what's in here. There were two pictures, a newspaper clipping, a key, and a tape inside. Looks overexposed. I can't make much out. I think I see trees in the background, but most of the picture is just bright white.
Yeah, pretty much. I could... one of the simplest fucking things.
Grandpa in uniform with two other men. Something is handwritten on the back. Flight training. McConnell Air Force Base, 1941. Tragic drowning in Conwell Springs. An early morning on Sunday the 14th, a teenage girl found dead near Conwell Lake. The girl is survived by her mother, father, and younger brother. The funeral service will be held at Conwell Cemetery on the 21st of July. The notice is dated July 15th, 1975. Tragic story. I wonder why Grandpa saved this. It's a small key, fairly modern design. No identifying tag, unfortunately.
Nice one, Doppel. You now understand.
You've reached the Rain residence. Leave a message after the beep.
Hello, Joseph, Mrs. Rain. It's me, Charles.
I thought I'd give you a call.
Okay, now I'm Erica
like just had her firstborn. It's a boy. Thankfully, he looks nothing like his father. Listen, I was thinking maybe you'd like to come and visit. And what about your little Kathy? Maybe she wants to see the baby. Well, anyways, hope to see you soon. All the best. Bye.
You people make me sick. We're never coming back. Don't call, don't write. If you ever try to contact us, I will call the police.
Joseph, you there? It's me, Cocky. It happened to me too. And I'm not going to tell any of those bastards. They got it all wrong. You're the only one I trust now. Just call me back as soon as you can.
I wonder who this Cocky is.
Yeah. Cock. Off my screen.
Nah.
It's me, Cocky. Sure. Stop.
Oh, hello, dear.
Yeah, I remember doing like my first point and click game was Broken Sword, first one, and I remember back in them days you didn't have. Have internet or anything like that, so we just you know, worked it out.
Mind if we talk for a bit, Grandma?
Not at all, dear. What's on your mind?
Might have been bed.
Can you tell me anything about McConnell Air Force Base?
It's not very far from Conwell Springs. Joseph was stationed there for some time during the war. I believe they're still training young pilots there today.
So, when did Grandpa enlist in the Air Force?
Oh, it was barely past the honeymoon when Joseph left to fight in that terrible war, together with his best friend Charles and my brother Andrew. Those were nerve-wracking years. I was so worried, I thought I would burst. Every short visit from Joseph was a joy, but he kept going back to the front, to my great dismay. When I told Joseph about being pregnant with your father, he finally realized that enough was enough. He had done his duty. Shortly thereafter, he returned to a quiet farmer's life in this very house, helping your great-grandfather with the crops until he passed.
Do you know anything about a young girl drowning around here?
Oh, yes. It was the saddest thing. She was only 16. We never really knew the family. They preferred to keep to themselves.
Do you remember the name of the girl or her family?
I'm awfully sorry, dear. I just can't recall.
That's okay, Grandma. I was just wondering why Grandpa would have wanted to save this.
Joseph was always affected by the tragedy of others. Perhaps he wanted to do something for the family. In any case, he didn't speak to me about it.
Does the nickname Cocky mean anything to you?
Sounds vaguely familiar. It reminds me of the aviator call signs Joseph and his friends gave one another. Joseph was vigilante. I can't count the number of times he got into trouble for breaking the rules. To this day, I have no idea how he always managed to land on his feet.
Must be hereditary, given the things I've gotten away with. Every time I wake up, I am genuinely surprised that I'm not in jail.
I'm sure it's not that bad, dear.
But to get back to the subject, you don't have any idea of who this Cocky is?
I'm afraid not, but the Air Force might be a good place to start.
Although I'm going to play Broken Sword 4, when I did get the graphics card, it couldn't run it. It was too good. Yeah, I think a HD remaster of the Broken Sword series would be awesome. I do hope for that. But the Broken Sword 3 and 4, I'd just say skip it if I'm honest. The whole 3D PS2 era was just awful in my opinion. I mean, it was nice to kind of see George in a different light, George and Nico, but it wasn't what Broken Sword was, in my opinion. You know, I figured it out. Grandma's a serial killer who murdered everyone, fooled by her gentle old lady disguise. Shit.
I don't see a reason to ask.
Yeah, fair enough.
Look at this photo I found in the locked briefcase.
Goodness, I haven't seen that picture in years. This was taken when Joseph was stationed at McConnell Air Force Base. That's him, right there on the left.
What about the other two?
I don't remember the name of the smiling man in the back. The gentleman on the right was Joseph's best friend, Charles Wade.
Do you recognize this key, Grandma? I found it in the attic.
I'm afraid not, dear.
Do you know anything about this story, Grandma?
Not much, dear. It was the saddest thing. The girl was only 16 years old. We never really knew the family. They preferred to keep to themselves.
Do you remember their names?
Let me think. I'm awfully sorry, dear. I just can't recall.
That's quite all right, Grandma. I was just wondering why Grandpa would have wanted to save this.
Joseph was always deeply affected by the tragedy of others. Perhaps he wanted to do something for the family to ease their pain. In any case, he didn't speak to me about it.
Okay.
No, it's all for the storyline. Yes, the fact they came away from Papa Point and Clip was good. It did spoil it, I agree, but yeah, but even the story was kind of, I don't know, it weren't as well as good in my opinion. I think they were too busy focusing on the hardware and graphics and all that stuff to kind of really focus on the story. But I mean, Broken Sword, it's always good.
Grams, can you tell me anything about this picture?
I shall see you tomorrow.
It looks awfully bright. Perhaps something was wrong with the camera.
Yeah, maybe. I should try to figure something out tomorrow at the university. I already showed her. What can you tell me about Charles Wade?
Well, I do know he has made quite a name for himself since he and Joseph went to war together. Apparently, he came up with some brilliant piece of engineering for the airplanes. They use it everywhere now.
Any idea how to get in touch with him?
I'm afraid not, dear. I haven't seen him for years. He and Joseph grew apart before you were born.
Any particular reason for that?
Not that I know of.
What other point and clicks did I play? All the Broken Sword series. Yeah, the entire Blackwell collection. Pretty much every Wadget Eye game you can think of, I've played. Wadget Eye Games being the company. Any game that they produced or directly created, I've probably played. So yeah, all the Blackwell series, Gemini Rue, Golden Wake, Godlight, that's their newest one. Can't think of the other ones. Monkey Island I've done. Secret of Monkey Island 1 and 2. Again, I didn't touch the 3D version.
Gotta go, Grams. Talk to you later.
Bye, Kathy.
Techno Babylon as well. Wadget Eye. Really awesome, but gruesome. Which was cool as well. Go. Was it a futuristic one? Yeah, Gemini. Beneath the Steel Sky. I really wanted to play that. I'm pretty sure I've got it on my computer somewhere. But I remember not being able to get past like a certain bit or like just the start entirely.
Damn. No Charles Wade in here. Was worth a shot, but being rich and famous and all, I guess he's got a hidden number. No hit for Wade Industries either, but it was kind of a long shot for them to have an office in this small county anyway. I should try to get a hold of him some other way. No result for that. Nope, couldn't. All right, got it.
Yeah, it does seem really hard. I'll have to play it at some point and just, like, have you go for it with me.
Nah.
McConnell Air Force Base, how can I help you?
Hi. I was just wondering if you had time to answer a few questions.
Sure thing, ma'am. Ask away.
Discworld? No, didn't play that either.
I'm trying to get a hold of Charles Wade. Would you happen to know how to reach him?
I'm sorry, ma'am, but Charles Wade is a public figure. He has explicitly asked us not to provide his contact details to anyone.
Is there any way you could make an exception? I really need to talk to Mr. Wade.
No can do. I can't really help you out unless you have some sort of official business.
I do have official business. I'm Deputy Reagan. I'm calling from Conwell Springs Sheriff's Department.
Nice try. Do you know what caller ID is? I can clearly see that you're not calling from the station. Goodbye.
Damn, I can't pull that off if I call from here.
Hi, this is Eileen speaking.
Hey, it's me, Kat.
Oh, hi, what's up?
Wait, you mean Discworld 1 and 2?
I'm trying to contact Charles Wade. You know, the industrialist?
Wow, really? Why?
It's complicated, but he knew Grandpa back in the day. They went to war together.
Huh, must be super hard to get in touch with a person like that.
Yeah. I'm finding that out.
Maybe you could ask someone in the Air Force, if he used to serve with your granddad, I mean.
Yeah, could be worth a shot. I'm trying to find this guy, but all I have is his nickname, Cocky.
Well, what do you know about the guy?
Not much. I think he was in the Air Force and served with Grandpa.
Maybe you could try to find somebody in the Air Force who knew him then?
Yeah, that might be worth a shot. I'm trying to track down this young girl who drowned in the lake here.
Okay. How hard can a dead person be to track down? They tend to stay in one place, you know.
Ha, very funny, E. I don't even know her name, just when she died.
Oh, well, there must be some way to connect a name to that date.
Yeah, maybe. I don't need to ask. I don't need to ask. Okay.
Bye, Kathy.
Oh yeah, super weird phone call to just randomly have. What's this world like then, Double?
How's the paperwork coming along, Lenny?
Okay, I guess. Maybe halfway through.
That's no good.
Hey.
Hi there.
Could you...
Sure, I needed to puke.
Good to know. Guess what? He's having some kind of fit in there.
Not again.
Here we go.
Space, how can I help you?
Hi. I was just wondering if you had time to answer a few questions.
Sure thing, ma'am. Ask away.
I'm trying to get a hold of Charles Wade. Would you happen to know...
I'm sorry, ma'am, but he has explicit...
Is there any way you can make an exception? I really need to talk to Mr. Wade.
Oh, can do. I can't really help you out unless you have some sort of official business.
I do have official business. I'm Deputy... Reagan, I'm calling from Conwell Springs Sheriff's Department.
I can see that you're actually calling from the station. You say you're a cop? You don't sound like a cop.
What the hell is that supposed to mean? It's just because I'm a woman, right? Women don't belong in law enforcement? Is that what you're saying? That's so sexist.
Now that's hardly what...
Do you have any idea what I have to go through every day? Nobody takes me seriously. The dirty looks, the sexual innuendos, I've...
Relax, okay? I'll check the files. It's 555-7641.
Thanks, buddy.
Wade residence.
Hi, this is Kathy Rain. I'm calling for Charles Wade.
He doesn't live here anymore. What's this about? What do you want with my father?
I'd just like to have a quick word with Mr. Wade. It's about my grandfather, Joseph Rain.
You're 20 years late, girl. My father has neither time nor energy to deal with you people.
But...
This conversation is over. Unless my father explicitly says he wants to talk to you, it's not going to happen.
What a stuck-up, overclass witch. Well, she hasn't heard the last from me. I'm going to talk to that old man one way or another.
She... That's a charming daughter, yeah.
McConnell Air Force...
Hi.
Sure thing.
What can you tell?
This is one of the oldest Air Force bases in the U.S., established during World War I. The main purpose of it is to train fighter pilots. The McConnell Flight School is well-renowned all around the country. In the late 80s, the school started accepting a limited number of civilian applicants due to the high demand. Some of the most famous dogfighters in U.S. history, such as Ethan Fireball Jenkins, Joseph Vigilante Rain, and Brett Xavier Myers, trained at this very base. Charles Wade, the great industrialist, did too. Some claim that many of his revolutionary ideas came from the former chief mechanic here, the late Niles Bloom.
Interesting. Thanks for the history lesson. I don't see a reason. Do you know anything about what happened to Joseph Rain in 81?
I know that he was no longer stationed here at the base at that time. He'd left the Air Force decades earlier. But as a Conwell Springs citizen, sure, I've heard the rumors just like everybody else. How he was found by the sheriff, all messed up, walking out of the woods with some kind of unexplained brain damage.
Any theory as to what he was doing out there?
I'm afraid not, ma'am. But I'm positive that it had nothing to do with this base or our operations here.
Okay, what can you tell me about his service at McConnell?
Well, Joseph Rain is a legend around here. His pile of medals weighs more than my car. I was fortunate enough to meet him before he suffered his injury, and I must say, what an inspiring man. I'm positive that he would have made general if he'd stuck around.
Any idea of why he quit? He looks so happy in the pictures from the war.
Oh, your family, ma'am?
Granddaughter.
Well, then I'm sorry for your loss. I heard about his recent passing.
Appreciate it, buddy. So, about him quitting.
I shouldn't speak ill of the dead, but some say the war broke him. PTSD. Me? I don't think so. When I met him, he had this aura about him, like he wasn't afraid of anything. Maybe it was his guilt. He ended a lot of lives, but that's just me speculating.
Gotcha. Thanks for the thoughts. Do you recognize the aviator call sign, Cocky?
Afraid not, ma'am. I know all the call signs here, and I'm positive it's not one of them.
This isn't current, though. It might have been used as early as World War II.
Oh, that's unfortunate. We don't keep any official records of call signs. The only option I can think of is to get a hold of somebody who was around back then.
Any suggestions?
The only person I can think of who is still alive would be Charles Wade.
All right, thanks.
My pleasure, ma'am. Anything else I can help you with?
All right, that's all.
Goodbye, ma'am.
I have no idea what that just was.
Various notices. A bunch of cops lining up for a photo. Land of the free.
You get to play the X-Files point-and-click game. Is that the one that was like all of it was just kind of like actual footage and still images and stuff like that? Going bed. I'll join you in a minute. Get a bit tired. Yeah, that's the one. I remember playing it on PS1.
Oh,
at some
hello,
point.
Dear.
You check the cemetery for the girl. There's no.
I've already searched.
I've got no name for her, so it'd be kind of hard. Unless I had to kind of look at all the graves and see who drowned. Oh yeah, shit.
Lanny, I need you to do something.
How can I help, boss?
It's my mother's birthday.
PC had 7 discs. Well, I guess I mean it's a lot of videos.
Hey.
Hey.
Sure. Good to know. Guess what?
Dirty Death won't
He's
be
having
enough.
Some kind of fit in there. Here we go. Maybe there's something in here about that drowning. Nope. Looks like I'm gonna need her name. Lots of police.
I was hoping that would work.
Nope. I got the key already. I got the key. Fax machines. The pinnacle of modern technology. I got the key. I got the key. Just a phone. Just a phone. Must be a pop.
Yeah, we'll try it.
Hmm.
Yeah, I'll speak to you tomorrow, Doppel. I'm gonna go to bed soon, lads, because it's getting late.
Tragic drown. In early morning on Sunday the 14th, a girl is survived by her mother, father, and younger brother. The funeral service will be held at Conwell Cemetery on the 21st of July. The notice is dated July 15th, 1975. It said, all right, this is the right date. Looks like her name was Lily Myers. I should try to get a hold of her family. I wonder what that kid is doing here all alone. Hey, kid.
Hi, yourself.
What are you doing?
None of your business.
Huh. I like you, kid. You're not here alone, right? Where's your mom?
Oh, she's around.
I don't see her.
You must be blind or something.
I'll go look for your mom, okay? Don't go anywhere.
Whatever.
I should go look. I'm gonna find out what happened to you, Grandpa. I promise. The grave is brim. I shouldn't leave. No reason to. It says. Kid?
The fuck?
Guess he found his mom.
Oh, he's a fucking ghost.
I never thought I'd return to this place. Conwell Springs. Looks smaller than I remember it.
Just stun gun the body, yeah. Just fucking stab him. Not be much, won't be anything in the fucking poem books from 1975, I'd thought.
She's been dead for 2 decades. I could try to find someone in her family, but I'll need a full name. She's been dead for.
Oh, this is where you go to the police station.
Hey, Sheriff, what's the deal with that bum?
What bum?
Hey.
Huh?
Good. Get. He's having some.
Yeah, I'm.
Here we go.
Gonna go to bed soon.
Okay, that's there's gotta be something in here about Lily enjoyed Myers' the stream. Death.
See you tomorrow.
Okay, what do we have here?
Mentions of this call by a resident near Cornwall Lake who reports that a young female, approximately 16 years old, had been found dead floating in the water, presumably drowned in the lake. Officers arrive at the scene, the EMT is en route, delayed by fog, the body is fully clothed and there are no apparent signs of foul play, incident declared as a likely accident. Sweep of residents reveal a suicide note matching victim's handwriting. Witness reports earlier earlier mental health problems. EMT finally arrived. The girl is declared dead by medical personnel and transit and transports to the city morgue. Coroner's report received. Cause of death is determined to be drowning. No, it's in a time of struggle. Suicide confirmed.
Hmm. Looks like somebody did a Virginia Woolf. I wonder if there's more to it.
Right, and people, then we will carry that on tomorrow. But yeah, thank you very much for coming, guys. I do hope you have enjoyed the stream. And I'll be seeing you tomorrow as usual. For more streams. Thank you very much for coming. I shall see you later. Bye, everyone.